G'day everyone, Alex here from Paperform, and today I'm going to be looking at two platforms, Airtable and Notion. Both powerful tools with amazing functionality and two of Paperform's most popular integrations. So I'm going to be comparatively looking at each platform and when and why you should choose to use one instead of the other, or if they can even be used in unison. Now, I'll break down this video into six chapters or topics. That way we can look at each platform, get a better understanding, and then come to a conclusion. Now, I'll start off this video by stating that both platforms are database-centered tools. Notion, which was initially a note-taking tool, has made a name for itself as a handy all-in-one productivity suite. You can manage products, brainstorm new ideas, document processes, organize meetings, and manage your data. You can even create quick and simple websites. Check out this personal portfolio I whipped up in a matter of minutes. I will admit that I'm a huge advocate for Notion. I love this damn tool. I even planned my upcoming vacation to Thailand using it. But I promise I won't provide a biased opinion on either platform. Airtable is a front runner when it comes to data management. It allows users to create and manage data in a user-friendly format. I would consider Airtable as a spreadsheet on steroids. It combines the functionality of a spreadsheet along with tools and features to better visualize, share, collect, and manage your data. Use it as a project tracker, research software, product catalog, event planner. There really isn't a limitation to how you can use it. Here I used Airtable to organize an upcoming dinner event. This includes managing the guests, event planning, dishes, and inventory. Let's complete a super quick and easy build using the free plans offered by both. Now, to create these YouTube videos, I follow a content plan, which is a pretty common use case for both platforms. On Notion, I have the ability to use the quick slash commands to build a database with speed. From here, I can rename my properties and change the property types, assign items, and add other properties. Let us add a publish date, boom. Selecting the new item I've created, which is the video I'm currently recording at this very moment, Airtable versus Notion. You can then begin expanding on your data items, adding notes for your research, a simple to-do list, include a script, and even embed a storyboard or thumbnail. Notion works in a block system. Here we can view all available blocks, which are not just limited to database types. From here, you can create new views of your database and filter how the data is viewed to better visualize and understand your data, manage your projects, and document anything and everything. Or I could head to Notion's template gallery where I can easily find a content calendar template and begin my building process from there. I can even find a template to better organize my outfits for the week so I'm not stressed each morning making sure that my fit is on point. I will note though that Notion's template gallery is not only contributed to by the Notion team, but also the Notion community. So you're bound to find a template and see how far you can actually push this platform. Airtable offers a more basic template list. However, in saying that, you have the ability to purchase extensions for your database through Airtable's marketplace. These extensions focus more on how you can utilize your data, import or export your data, and connect with other platforms. This particular extension allows you to generate your daily horoscope, giving you a better visualization of which planet you can blame your bad behavior on. But let's jump into Airtable and build a content calendar. I'll select to create a new base. That green is a bad choice. Let's quickly change this before I vomit. And we'll title this base content calendar. You'll notice a big difference here. While Notion's building process is like that of a text editor, Airtable is, as I stated earlier, a spreadsheet on steroids. So let's quickly change these properties, adding a title, the status of a video in production, an assignee, and a publish date. Now, Notion will allow me to house my script directly within my database. As I stated, it's basically a text editor. While with Airtable, I'll need to house my script elsewhere, such as a Google Doc. So let us include a URL property to link my script. We can now create new views of our base and filter how that data is viewed. If we select automations, we will see how powerful and connected Airtable really is. We can set up our base to directly email or send a Slack message when an action occurs, meaning the content team can receive live updates and collaboration is a breeze. We can use interfaces to visualize and generate a front door of our base, so collaborators only need to view the relevant information or data. We won't dive too deep into each of these platforms, otherwise we could spend all day building amazing things. So now let us look at sharing capabilities. How well can you share your databases, workspaces, pages, whatever you build with others and your team? With Notion, you can share pages and make them public, allowing anyone with the link to view them. And you can also share pages and workspaces with other Notion users, giving them access to either view or edit. That could be a database within a page, a process and procedure, or even a to-do list. Multiple users can edit and make changes to the same page in real time, meaning it's incredibly easy to collaborate. You can use Notion to create teams, invite team members, and allow them to collaborate and share pages and databases. With Airtable, you can share entire bases with other Airtable users, giving them access to view or edit all information available. You can share specific views of a base with others and filter the information that they see. Much like with Notion, you can share a link to a particular base or even a specific view of a base to someone that doesn't need an Airtable account to see it. And like Notion, you can create teams and invite team members to collaborate on projects. Not much of a difference in regards to the sharing capabilities, is there? Which brings us to integrations and automations. How can you connect your Notion or Airtable with other platforms? Airtable is definitely ahead of Notion in this regard. With a large number of native integrations, you can easily connect your bases to other platforms without needing to leave the platform. When you update your Airtable bases, you can automatically send an email via Gmail, post to your business's LinkedIn or Facebook, plus much more. The list of possible automations with Airtable is bloody magnificent. Notion has indeed begun releasing more native integrations like linking your Jira database or showing Slack messages directly within a page. However, while you can internally visualize information or data from another platform, the actions you make within Notion cannot affect said platform unless that platform has made the effort to create their very own integration with Notion using Notion's public API. In saying that though, Notion did recently acquire automate.io, so keep your eyes open. Unless you want to embed a Figma design or a Miro thought board, you're going to have to use an integration platform or Notion's API to connect and achieve other things. While Airtable already offers a sweet list of native automations built within, meaning you don't have to leave and spend an extra penny on an integration platform, nor get dizzy trying to mess with their API capabilities. Of course, Paperform offers native integrations with both platforms. When your Paperform receives a new form submission, you can automate the creation of new records within your Airtable bases, as well as content, updating database items, and creating pages within your Notion. Furthermore, you can easily create an online form from a Notion database in a matter of clicks. Now, both platforms offer a free plan that achieves a lot. However, like with any SaaS platform, if you want to get the most out of it, you're going to need to upgrade to a paid plan. Notion's pricing is definitely on the lighter side, and this could be attributed to the stance of it being a text editor first and foremost. Now, at the time of this recording, Notion's basic plan, or cheapest, is at $8 per seat per month, which is incredible value for money. This includes unlimited blocks, unlimited uploads, 100 guests, collaborative workspaces, and so much more. While Airtable's basic plan is $10 per seat per month. For this price, you receive unlimited bases, 6,000 records per base, 3 extensions per base, 5 gigabytes of attachments per base, and much, much more. Again, exceptional value for money. I can say no bad word about either platform's pricing structure. However, I will say this. Notion is an exceptional tool, but it is a basic tool. Airtable is a damn powerhouse, and the higher tier plan of $20 per seat per month is still an absolute steal. So, which is the better tool? Well, neither. It'd be like asking, is Kelly Slater or Serena Williams better? You just can't give an answer. They are both incredible and powerful team productivity and individual productivity tools. Airtable does an amazing job of storing and using your data, while Notion's stance is that of a platform that allows you to document and elaborate on the data it contains. So neither platform trumps the other. Both platforms are epic tools in their own right. And if you were to ask me if you should use one of the platforms, I'd be asking you, why aren't you already? If you're a creative thinker, obsessed with organization, need a platform to document, brainstorm ideas, or need a simple database to collaborate with a broader team, then Notion is for you. While the functionality available with Airtable far exceeds that of Notion, and there's no argument there. So if you're looking for a solution to better organize, manage, visualize your data, along with built-in tools to see better data reporting, better share your data and connect it with other platforms, then Airtable is your go-to. Furthermore, using both tools together is going to enhance such a great power. Well, that's it from me. If this has been a helpful video, let us know. Hit the thumbs up and subscribe to the channel for more helpful videos like this. And I'd like to know in the comments below, what other platforms do you use? Whether it be for note-taking, brainstorming ideas, project collaboration, or data housing, I'm eager to know. Good luck, and I wish you all the best.